Okay, concerning health, this is for Rastafari Foundation Health Department. Now, the spirit. We must comprehend, understand, and realize that the spirit should be in control of all the mechanics within the human body, which is our vessel, our vehicle. To put this in an example form, the brain. The brain is often treated as if it is the driver, but that is wrong. That is a wrong interpretation of the way things should be, of a holistic individual, a man, women, or children created to the image of his creator. The spirit is the driver. The spirit is in control, should be in control at all times of all mechanics, flesh, and different organisms within the human vessel, which is our body, which is our the vessel that is used to experience those things which need be experienced, that we can move on ahead to better, bigger, greater things. Basically, before we go off track, we must learn that the spirit should be in control of the engine. So the human body is a vehicle, the brain is only an engine, but the driver is the spirit conducting all things and behind the controls of all things, of all mechanisms and workings within the human body. So just by knowing, just by acquiring knowledge, we shall be set free, because we shall know the truth, and by knowing the truth, we shall be set free. And thus, whom the Son of the living God, Jesus Christos, has freed is free indeed. Now, whenever we come across an ailment, a discomfort, a dis-ease, we must learn and research concerning those symptoms so that we could get to the root of the issue, of the problem, so that we can correctly interpret and give a correct interpretation of the grounds which lead to the present judgment, which is the ailment, the pains, the, you know, all that. So now, we gave a different, it's not the same as we presented on another video. This is concerning just the knowledge of a certain already diagnosed problem. For instance, an individual who has half of his face without any sense or nervous activity, you know, kind of when people become paralyzed from one side of their face or something like that. Just by researching and studying concerning that, ones will make it that much better, and you'll come to learn and understand that there's two canal lines, two nerve vein canal systems, that they're tiny. And the thing is, this is very common because there's only one that leads to the control of half of this nervous system, and the nervous canal that leads to the control of this half of all facial expression, feeling, and sense and stuff like that. So once you know that, then you know that if for any reason there's anything clogging up or obstructing the flow of whatever it is that flows through these nervous system canals, or call it what you may, I'm sure there's a proper term for these actual parts within our vessel, but at this point in time it's not necessary. Just to get the idea or the basic vision of what we're trying to explain, and what we're trying to explain just came to mind is the word, you know. We have an idea in our minds, and now we're speaking that, which should be able to kind of link ones into comprehending what it is that we're actually thinking, the expressed image. So now that we do some study behind that, then we learn that there's certain things that ones use to stimulate the nervous system, such vitamins as B12. You can find those on your energy drinks and stuff like that. Guarava or something like that. You can find those in your energy drinks. What is the purpose of that? They try to stimulate your nerve. They stimulate your nervous system, so you get wired. You get amped up, you get excited, you get some get a rush, some get energetic, whatever. The whole purpose is to stimulate that nervous system, hopefully just push out anything out of the way that may be obstructing the flow or path of those messages, those neurons or whatever the case may be. But that's one attempt. Just by knowing this, it makes it a whole lot better, because we don't need to go out and buy energy drinks. Anything that is purchasable outside of the human body is in fact already incorporated within the human body. So just by knowing this, the spirit then takes the initiative to realize what it can go ahead and do. Retrieving some information from your stored documents, it allows the spirit movement into a circumstance situation where it could actually say, okay, so all we need is this. And the spirit goes on and demands on the controls for these certain chemicals to be released at whatever amount is necessary in order for this ailment to be treated and be done away with and discarded and abandoned forever. It's that simple. Just learning about the symptoms, the reactions, the causes, just being informed of whatever it is we're confronted with makes it so much better, because we may not be taking any decisions. By we mean this soul, this ego, this idea of what we think it's even us. Then the spirit says that we, that ego, that does not want to be let go of, if we wait for him to act on this, nothing will ever get done. He don't even have a clue of what's going on. So the spirit, now being well-fed with knowledge and information and truth, can go on ahead and do things for you that you never thought it would be able to do. Now, this may sound far-fetched, but this is in reality the way it works. Just informing yourself, but one, I cannot teach you. You have to receive it for yourself in order for your spirit to work upon that which it has received. And it's that simple. I mean, it makes it that much better. Because the human body is perfect, formed in the shape and image of a perfect creator. It has not been educated to overcome circumstances and has been made weak into pretending or assuming that circumstances are greater than he. And thus we deteriorate as time goes along with these ideas that people say, oh, there's nothing you can do, you have to go to a doctor, you have to do this, you have to do that, that's impossible, that cannot be done. And so we become vulnerable to this idea that a circumstance or disease or ailment or pain or discomfort is greater than us, and we must treat and welcome this discomfort for the rest of our lives until we die. Along with that, pay some other individual to treat and welcome and make feel comfortable this discomfort within your spirit. But this is the ego, the imaginary, the pretend we that accepts this. But within each and every one of us is the spirit of courage, the natural spirit that we have, will, and are overcoming. We must take on this spirit, this the only thing that is true, the courage and the knowledge that we have, we are, and we will always overcome circumstances, for we are not placed in circumstances that cannot be overcome, for we would thus not even have any idea that that circumstance even exists, for we would not be prepared to accept something that we're not even capable of understanding to exist, and thus it would not be a problem. So before we get all caught up into that, which is extremely necessary and important to comprehend, just knowing. Knowing makes all the difference. Because then the spirit could go on ahead doing those things which are best for truth. Not for, oh, I don't eat apples and oranges. That's the ego. If you were you, and you were holy, you would know that it's not about, oh, I don't eat apples. It's that which is true is true. And I am of truth, and so truth, you know, magnetizes with truth, and only truth can be. So that's how separate, that's an example of how separated we have become from what we claim to be us, when in reality is no part in truth, you know. So, and this goes for everything. This isn't only, like, if you want to change your eating habits, study, learn, because then you don't have to depend on the ego, on this false idea of me. The spirit will be like, no. It'll get you away from wanting to desire something that's not for you, because it's not of truth. It will not magnetize, and it will repel. It will not vibrate at the equal frequency that which is of truth. And so slowly but surely, the spirit will gain control more and more of the human vessel, and you'll be like, nah, I'm not really interested in that kind of food anymore, for some reason, don't even know why, but it's because you sought the Almighty, you sought the Word, the reason, and you were interested in learning, and by learning, you became to know, and by knowing, it became wisdom, it became applicable, and thus, you become whole, and, you know, shalom.